Hey, Harvest family, it's Pastor Greg here, and just wanted to share a few minutes with you, hopefully to encourage you and to share some things that are on my heart. There were so many things I would love to talk to you about, and so I had to prioritize one thing, and what we're going to talk about this morning is our personal intimacy with Jesus. I can't think of anything more important. God will use that to give you encouragement and hope and strength, and then use that to propel you. Your intimacy with Him will propel you to reach out to your friends and neighbors during this time too. So let's just talk about our quiet times with the Lord, building intimacy. That's what a quiet time really is designed to do, is to build your intimacy with Jesus. And I'm going to give you five P's. All right. So if you've got a piece of paper, you can write down five P's and then we'll just go one by one. The first one is passion. The first one is passion. Passion for Jesus comes through personal relationship. Think about a marriage, and you remember when I preached, I talked about that Jesus is the groom and we are the bride, and He looks at us. He uses that illustration in the Scriptures a lot about us and Him. We're married. And you can't have a passionate relationship unless you spend quality time together. And I think what happens a lot of times in our quiet times, we use them to try to get things that we need from Jesus. And he's willing to give for sure, and He'll do that. But our quiet times are really not to get things from Him, but to get with Him. All right, He's the living God. Let me read Psalm 63 and listen to David's heart about getting with God. Oh God, You are my God. Earnestly I seek You. My soul thirsts for You. My flesh faints for You, as in a dry and weary land where there is no water. Can you hear the passion of David to get together with the personal living God? And so I want to encourage you to have that passion. If you don't have it right now, just repent of that and just tell God, I'm sorry. I need to refuel my passion for You. And then spend time with Him. That's how you build a relationship with your spouse. You spend time with them. You get to study them. You get to learn from them. You get to enjoy them. And God wants you to enjoy His relationship with Himself. And so that's the first P, is passion. The second P is practice. There's no way around this. To build intimacy with Jesus, you have to practice spiritual disciplines. And there's a lot of different ways that you can draw near to Him, draw near to the living God. And so let's just talk about a few of those. First is the Word of God. All right, the Word of God, the Bible, is a way that God has revealed Himself to us. And to get to know Him, we need to study it and we need to read it, right? God has been so good to preserve the Word so we can know who He is and to get close to Him. And so study and read it. I use this tool. It's called the 1718 series. It's based on Deuteronomy 1718, where Moses tells the people that they're going to want a king over them. And he prophesies that the kings should write out the Word of God in their own hand. And if they do that, they'll be careful to keep it and they'll be careful to lead the people well and teach their children it. And so I write out the verses of God in here. On the left of this side of the page, I write out like 7 or 8 verses a day. And then on this side, I write what God is teaching me. And so I've done I think I've done 23 books of the Bible like this, where I've written them out with my own hand and my own personal commentary, 8 verses at a time. It gets me to slow down and really contemplate what I'm reading. And there's lots of different ways to read the Bible. You can go online and get lots of different reading plans, read the Bible in a year, or a psalm and a proverb or whatever. There's lots of different ways, but get God's Word into your heart, and that will fuel your intimacy with Jesus. The second way that we practice spiritual disciplines to get more intimate with Jesus is through memorizing His Word. I'm working on Psalm 86:11 right now. It says, Teach me, O Lord, to walk in Your ways, that I may walk in Your truth, and then unite my heart to fear Your name. All right, I did it. I'm getting it. And so memorizing God's Word gives us so much help in our daily times. It makes us think of Him during the day. God will call these things to mind by His Spirit. We can use them to help other people. Memorizing God's words is a really important spiritual discipline. The third one is meditating on His Word. Kind of His Word is the theme of the first three, meditating on it. Let's take Psalm 86:11, where it says, teach me, God. So God, I'm so thankful that You want to teach, that You have so much knowledge, and I can mine the depths of Your riches by studying Your Word, and You want to instruct me. It says, teach me. It's not like teach the peoples. You care about me. It's a personal thing, God. What a blessing to know that the God of the universe, is concerned about teaching me. Teach me, oh, Lord, oh. That's my emotion to you, God, like David had in Psalm 63. I long to be near you. I long to want you. Hear my expression when I say, oh, oh, Lord. Lord, you are my master. You are in control of my life. Forgive me when I try to put myself on the throne instead of following you. Teach me, oh, Lord, that I may walk in your truth. I love, God, that you call our relationship a walk. I feel so secure knowing that you're with me and you're beside me as I'm walking through these days. Even though this virus stuff is crazy, I know you're with me. You're walking with me, God, that I may walk in your truth. Your word is truth. I'm thankful that I can trust it, that every promise is true. And then unite my heart. God, I don't want to be double-minded. God, forgive me for that. Make me single-minded on you. And God, for those things that compete for your affection, God, would you help me suppress those so I can keep you on the throne where you rightfully deserve to be, that I can walk in your truth, unite my heart to fear your name. Oh, God, help me to be a God-fearing follower of you. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of, you see what I'm doing? I'm just meditating on God's word. I'm slowing down. That's a great discipline that gets you closer to Jesus. How about this worship? About 7-8 years ago, I started the discipline of personal worship times with Jesus. On Friday, I don't do Bible study. I get out 5 or 6 songs and I sing directly to God about how awesome he is. And I get in alone so no one hears me. No matter how good or bad a singer you are, it's awesome because you can just sing to God. And it's a really tender time between me and Jesus. And I just commend that to all of you, personal times of worship. All right. Next is prayer. I shared this a couple Sundays ago when I preached. This is a diary of private prayer by John Bailey. This changed my life. It changed my life. And this morning I went through this and I read his prayers on one side. And then I put all my prayers over here. And I start out, as I mentioned a couple weeks ago, with 2 attributes of God. And then I prayed a prayer of confession for my critical spirit I prayed for this morning. And then I prayed for myself, a bunch of things, joy, selflessness, a bunch of things, humility, dependence on him, fear, wisdom. My word for the year is gentleness. I prayed about that and a bunch of things. And then I pray for one of my kids each day. So I prayed for Michael this morning, love for him, protection. Then I pray for Chris. She gets prayed for every day, my wife. And then I pray for you. I prayed for the church, for joy, love, unity, that we would be humble together, that we would worship, grow in our fervency of worship. I prayed for provision for you during this season. I prayed for provision for our church. I prayed for your health. I prayed for our staff. I prayed for our ministry leadership team and for Roger, our operations director. I pray for him every day. I pray for our elders. I prayed for our church. I prayed for our school, Harvest Christian Academy, for the discipleship of the kids, for growth in our school, for the facilities there, for our staff. And then I pray for the lost. I pray for the lost in my life that I'm praying that they would come to see Jesus. But this has changed my life, this prayer journal. Prayer needs to be built into your disciplines. So that's the second P, is practice. Practice of spiritual disciplines to grow your intimacy with Jesus. The third P is place, all right? Jesus gives us a great example. He's always getting away to a solitary place, and he would encourage us to do the same. Get to a place where we can have solitude. Solitude is the absence of human activity. And we need the absence of human activity for God to do supernatural activity. All right? So get no noise. Get away. Find a place. No computers. No phone. No people. And go to the living God. You won't be able to consistently build your intimacy with Jesus if you don't have a good place. All right, so you got to maybe creative right now. You may have to go in your basement. You may have to get up early before other people in your house are, because now we're all in the house, a lot of us together. So find the place, go to the front room or something and get alone with God. So that's the third P. The fourth one is pattern, all right? Prioritizing and planning and protecting a daily routine will help you grow in your intimacy with Jesus. It's okay to have routine. But it's not okay to be stale. If your quiet times are stale, it's not because Jesus is stale. It's maybe because what you're doing is trying to just get from him instead of go to the living God. And so, but patterns are great. If you can build a pattern in your life, get up the same time every day or have the same routine, it'll help you grow closer to Jesus. So see if you can build a pattern, particularly now, you got to be a little more creative. Put that pattern in place and it'll help you grow closer to Him. And then the last P is people, all right? The last P is people. And what do I mean when I say people as it relates to our quiet time? Well, our daily quiet time is a solo journey. It's not meant to be done in isolation. If you really want to grow in your quiet times, get accountable to someone. Make some commitments and then follow back up with them. If you really, really want to get serious about your quiet times, get a partner and that you can share exactly what you're learning, and that'll really, really help you. And then lastly, as you're doing these things, these five P's, it should help you think about how and motivate you to share what God has given you in that personal intimacy with Him with others. And I want to talk about that for a minute in the midst of this season. I want to challenge you to do something. All of you have neighbors, whether you're in an apartment or in a house, you have neighbors. And I want to challenge you to do these things. I was talking to Dave Stone about this. He gave me these thoughts, and I think it's really, really great. These three questions, ask your neighbors. All right, go over to their house or write them a note. These three questions. First, how are you? How are you doing? Just ask them and listen. Number two, how can I pray for you? All right, and number three, how can I help meet a need for you? Those three questions. Get out of your house or, like I said, call them and just ask those three questions for your neighbors. There's no greater time than now. People are open to this. They're open to the things of the Lord. Everyone's searching. So draw near to Christ personally in your own intimacy and then be motivated by that to share it with others that they would grow their own intimacy. Maybe they need to be introduced to Jesus, or maybe they know Jesus, but they can grow deeper. Just open up, ask these questions and listen and then respond. The Spirit will guide you and God can use you in amazing ways in this season. Love you so much. I'm so thankful for our church. Thankful that we could be together. Looking forward to be worshiping with you again this weekend. Just know how much we care for you, and we love you. You are loved.